Hello everyone, welcome to Git tutorial. In our previous sessions, we have seen how to create branches and how to work with them. In this video, I'll be discussing about Git merge. Git merge is nothing but moving code from one branch to other branch. Let me show you that. See here, I have a repository called Prism repo with one branch called master with 14 commits. Now let me create another branch from this master branch. That's it. I'm going to create this branch. So my new branch has been created with the name CDT. Now what I'll do is I'll go to my master branch. Do some changes here. I'm going to update this file. In our previous sessions, we have already seen how to create branches and how to modify the files and commit. Now to modify this file, I'm going to click on this. Now I'm going to add some changes here. See here, I added this text by removing few lines here. Modified in master branch to test git merge from GitHub. This is the text I added by removing few other lines. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to commit the changes. I'm going to give this as the commit message and going to click on this commit changes. That's it. I committed this change to my master branch. Now if I go to my repository, I'm able to see 15 commits here. Now let me modify some other file here. I'm going to modify this second file.txt. I'm going to click on this edit icon. Here I'm going to remove this line and add some other line. So this text I added here, text added to test merge from GitHub. Now I'm going to commit this. I'm going to write this as a commit message, second file.txt modified to test merge. Now I'm going to commit the changes. Now if you observe, my change has been committed here. Now if I go to my repository, I'm able to see 16 commits here. But if I go to my CDT branch, let me open that CDT branch in other tab for better comparison. Whereas in my master branch, I have 16 commits. But in my CDT branch, I have only 14 commits. In my repository, I have total two branches. This CDT branch has been created from master branch when master had 14 commits. After that, I did some modifications and did two commits to master branch. Now the new changes what I made to master branch, that is 15th and 16th commit, the changes which are part of this 15 and 16 commits that I want in my CDT branch. How to get that is you just click on this new pull request. Now it is going to show you from where to where you want to merge the changes. I want to send the changes from master to CDT branch. You select the CDT branch here. This arrow indicates that I want to move the changes from master to CDT. And here I'm seeing that message able to merge. It means there is no issue in merging. If there is any issue like merge conflicts, if a same file has been modified in both the branches, then you will get a merge conflict. In our next sessions, I'll be discussing about how to solve the merge conflict as well. If you are not aware of that now, it's okay, ignore it. I'll explain in further sessions. Now see here, I don't have any issue with merging. Now I'm going to write the message here as merging from master to CDT. Here I have given this message and I'm going to click on this create pull request. That's it. After that, here I have to click on merge pull request. Before clicking this merge pull request, if you want to add any approval process, we can add that as well. As of now, you don't bother about that. That is optional actually. So if you want to add that, how to add that, I'll discuss in our further sessions. As of now, I don't have any approval process. So I want to merge the pull request. For that, I'm going to click on this merge pull request and then confirm merge. That's it. I got the changes from master to CDT branch. If I go to this repository, see here, master has 16 commits. If I click on this, see here, I'm able to see the commit IDs, which are nothing but version IDs. And here I'm able to see the commit messages. This is under master branch. Now, if I go to my CDT branch and refresh this. Now, if I go to my CDT branch, here I'm able to see 17 commits. If I click on this, see here, I'm able to see these two commits, which are from master branch. But we merge the code from master to CDT, right? That merge is also like a commit. Along with these two commits, a new commit ID has been generated in our CDT branch. However, we got the changes from master to CDT branch. This is how we merge the code between the branches. So far, we have seen how to merge the code from one branch to other branch from GitHub. Now, let me explain you the merge using git commands. Before that, let me show you the changes what we made in the 15th and 16th commit of master branch. The same changes we will be able to see in CDT branch. Let me show you them. If I go to CDT branch here, this file, if I open, then I'm able to see this text, what I made in master branch. Again, if I go to this file, I'm able to see this change as well. That's it. We got the code from master branch to CDT branch. Let me show you the same with git commands. For that, let me clone this repository to my local. Now I'm under git practice, which is my local directory. I'm going to clone my git repository. This is my repository. Let me get into that. These are the files I have under my repository. This is the text I have in this file. I just want to show you that I cloned the repository and I have the latest changes. Now I'm connected to master branch. Now what I will do is I'll modify a file here. This is the file I'm going to modify. Let me open it. I'm going to add some text here like this. From Git. That's it. I'm not modifying in GitHub. I'm going to modify it in Git. So let me save the changes. Now if I go to my git bash and type git status, I'm able to see the modified file. Let me add this to staging area. Let me commit it. I'm going to give this as a commit message. I'm going to push the change. I'm going to push it to master branch because I'm connected to master branch and I'm modified in master branch. So let me push it to master branch. That's it. My changes has been pushed. Now, if I go to my GitHub repository, after refreshing my repository, I'm able to see 17 commits in my master branch. Now, let me go back to my Git bash. Here, I'm connected to my master branch. Let me switch to CDT branch. Git checkout CDT. Here, I'm trying to merge the master branch changes to my CDT branch. For that, first I have to connect to my CDT branch. Then what I have to do is git merge master. I switched to CDT branch. So my current connected branch is CDT. Now I'm going to merge the changes from master branch to my current connected branch, which is CDT branch. Now if I tap enter, it is going to open a file. Here we have to enter the merge message. If you remember, even while merging the code in our GitHub, we used to enter one merge message. Here also we have to enter a proper merge message, but I'm not going to give anything. I'm going to leave it as a default one. What I'm seeing here in the yellow color, that is a default message. So just I'm going to save this. For that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on escape colon WQ. WQ means write and quit. That's it. My changes has been merged from master to CDT branch. Now, if I see my current connected branch, git branch, I'm connected to CDT branch. If I type this, see here, this is the change we made in our master branch. Now, after merging, we got the same change in our CDT branch. Now, I have to push the changes to our CDT branch. That's it. My changes has been pushed to GitHub. Now, if I go here and refresh this repository and get into CDT branch, here I'm able to see 19 commits. 17 commits was earlier commits. After that, this is the new commit what we got from master to CDT branch and the merge. Merge also generates one commit ID, right? That we are able to see here. If I go here, see here, this is the commit message I made. Testing git merge from git. Here, this was the previous merge what we did from GitHub. After that, we made one commit and after that, we got another merge. That is how we merge the code between branches. You can see this logs from our git as well. Now let me go to my git log. If I type here I'm able to see the commit messages 76CB330. So here the previous commit 3C177. If you click on quit, you will come out of this. Like this, you can see the log history for each and every branch. That's it for our today's session. In our next session, I'll be discussing about git ignore. You should not allow few types of files to commit. For example, if I am working for a Java project, after compilation, I'll be getting some .class files. My developer should not commit those .class files to my GitHub repository. How to do that? I'll be discussing in our next session. That's it for today's session. Please subscribe to our channel to get further updates. Thank you. Stay tuned.